The views and opinions expressed by participants in the following public affairs program do not necessarily reflect the position or beliefs of WDEF or its staff.
This is Point of View, celebrating a world record-breaking 62 years of quality public affairs programs from the studios of WDEF News 12, Chattanooga.
Hello, I'm Maurice Lewis, and thank you very much for joining us for this edition of Point of View. You have an idea. You want to get started. Who do you talk to? The preacher after the collection? No, well, maybe your aunt, uncle, friend, bartender? Well, what about a professional? Well, that's a question many of us have asked ourselves or might ask ourselves as we think about doing something that is different from what we normally would do. The word consultant comes to mind, and that's part one of this series of Point of View. Let's welcome from Rion Consulting Group. Rion is not like neon. It doesn't shine, but it is attractive because it does what?
As far as what we do for our
services?
Yeah. Well, we serve nonprofits and businesses doing consulting work in lots of different areas. We have a group of five consultants. So we do some fundraising for nonprofits. We have accounting work that we do for a CFO for hire. We have some strategy work that we do. And then, of course, my husband's really good on the IT and business.
I wanted to mention the fact that your last names are both Duval.
Yes.
That's right.
And we have Andre.
That's right.
And Angela, yes.
Well, how did you guys get into this business, and what's been the motivating factor that has kept you in it?
Well, first of all, we love what we do and are super thankful for the opportunity to do it. And after about 17 years for me, maybe 18 years for Angela, in a variety of roles, from serving in public sector through schools and also in other nonprofit and business organizations. We really desired a chance to go out and impact multiple organizations on a project-by-project basis.
Is that also part of your Christian philosophy?
Well, you know, our heart and our mind is mission-minded, and so we certainly are very much driven to see and to make an impact and to help organizations make an impact in the community.
So before an organization can make an impact, they have to get started.
That's right.
So what's step one for the average organization? And we're not talking about General Motors, we're talking about, you know, smaller and also nonprofits.
Mm-hmm. That's right, yeah, and that's mostly what we serve is small to medium-sized nonprofits and some businesses as well. And really, the decision, as you're saying, to get started, the first thing is to have a plan. And oftentimes, we have a desire, we have maybe a dream or a vision, but we lack the planning that can really take that vision and put it into a reality. Okay. And that's where we're able to come along and help to assess what that business requirement is or what that nonprofit's mission is and where they're not seeing the results, and to help them to create a plan.
You know, I see two words that flash in front of me. Number one would be fear, and then number two would be the adjustment.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's right. And what we find is the people we help either are struggling because they're experiencing some problem, some obstacle. It could be as a software change, or it could be some growth initiative that's, you know, not going well, some expansion, or they're trying to grow. So they're either in, you know, kind of in trouble, or they're doing okay, but they want to be doing better.
And the fear side of it is not wanting to try something different, mm-hmm. needing to listen to what you say as opposed to how they might have wanted to do it.
Mm-hmm. Right.
How do you work around that with companies?
I think you have to really hear them and really listen.
Oh, to listening.
Them. Yeah. I mean, a good consultant is really going to listen and really make a plan. I think that they agree to, that they're passionate about, that they can own, and then help them to see maybe why we would suggest some changes in different areas.
In a lot of cases, you're talking with organizations small and with your nonprofits, there have to be a series of meetings. And there are some things that you say on your website, that things that can really destroy a meeting. Mm-hmm. Run through that for us real quick, would you?
Yeah, so one of them is really not having a good facilitator of the meeting who can direct the meeting in a very purposeful manner and keep it from kind of growing and becoming really not effective at accomplishing the original objective. Another thing is really having too many people in the meeting, mm-hmm. not enough people in the meeting, or the wrong people in the meeting is another kind of pitfall that we see.
Every company or organization tends to have one, this person who just knows everything. You know, if you just listen to me, I could really tell you how to do it. Mm-hmm. They think that they want to be the boss. Mm-hmm. How do you get that kind of like anchor drag to work in harmony with your clients?
Mm-hmm. One thing that is core to our belief is that people support what they help to create. Mm-hmm. And so it's really about, it does play into the listening aspect of things, but it's really the drawing out and drawing people into the effort. Unfortunately, in our industry of consulting, we can sometimes be viewed as an adversary maybe, or a threat, I guess, to put it better.
To the status quo.
To the status quo. Mm-hmm. And so for those of us who are comfortable with the status quo and don't want to be disrupted, then mm-hmm. you know, sometimes that can be difficult.
In our final 2 minutes, we want to talk a little bit about donor management, often for nonprofits and what have you. The climate out here now, there is a lot of uncertainty in terms of which monies are going to be available. How important is it for your customers to understand how to manage a donor base?
Mm. Well, it's absolutely critical to the core of any nonprofit, the ability to manage the donor base. And maybe you want to mention?
Sure, I'll speak a little bit, and he can, if we want to talk about maybe the...
Well, you have less than a minute and a half, go ahead.
Well, the question, I guess, about, you know, Trump coming in, is, are things going to change, and how is that going to change? And I think anytime you have a change in president, those questions and those fears come up. So, but really what nonprofits need to do is make sure that they're getting their funds in different areas. So it could be the business area, it could be through private.
Diversify,
yes. Okay. So that if government does tend to, you know, back down, that they can...
Being a consultant, is it like you don't promise past performance is no measure for future returns?
Well, you know, every project is unique, every customer is unique, and so we find ourselves applying principles that can be consistent.
Ah, the consistency.
That's right, consistent principles, but we come fresh, you know, to each situation and willing to learn and willing to understand the uniqueness of each client. That's,
you know, important. I mentioned the word Christian a little bit earlier on because, you know, times are tough. There's a lot of competition out there for the available dollars. So it's important to have your message be clear, mm-hmm. to find out who you're trying to reach. How do you do that?
Well, you need a really strong marketing team for sure, and you really need to know who you are as an organization and who you want to target, and really know your donors. So if you have a strong fundraising team and really learn who your donors are, you can target their passions with what the organization does in different areas of the organization.
I know you guys are passionate about getting the word out about what you do. How do people reach you?
The best way is through our website, reonconsulting.com, R-E-O-N. consulting.com, and from there you can contact us very easily, and happy to set up a phone call and talk to anyone. And we like to say, if you're not sure if we can help, ask us anything.
So. There you go. That's the first step. Angela and I thank you both very much from Reon Consulting Group here in Chattanooga, Tennessee. One of the most important things about taking that first step is something that we'll discuss in section 2 when Point of View continues.
Welcome back to Point of View. I'm Nayada Kinsell. We've spoken about consulting, but now let's talk about business coaching. With me today is Linda Bullard, Murray Bullard, correct?
Yes, Linda Bullard.
We don't want to miss that that one name in there, right?
Actually, it's very important to me, yes.
Good. Tell me, we spoke about consulting,
yes,
in the previous segment.
Yes.
But what's the difference between consulting and business coaching?
Well, consulting is you are actually guiding a person with information that you are providing. Coaching is you're taking them on a journey that they have, and you're more or less letting them guide. So in coaching, when I'm coaching a client, then I'm actually coaching them using tools that they already have, and I am letting them lead the way. But when I'm consulting them, then I'm giving them tools that I possess, and I'm using my skills to build on what I know that they can be.
There's lots of areas for business consulting. You have picked a very particular one that is a booming industry in in our area. Please talk to us about more about that.
So what I'm doing is I do startups. Mm-hmm. So I take dreamers, which I am very happy that there are a lot of dreamers. I take dreamers from the dream to the implementation. So most of my clients are those who have disconnected with their dreams from ago. And I help them to reconnect, and then we build a solid plan and we implement that plan.
Are there times where you say, you know, dreams are sometimes meant to be kept in the dream world?
Well, I don't think there's ever a bad idea. I think there are some ideas that can be refined and fine-tuned. And a lot of times when they get into it, because I work with several agencies here in the city, so a lot of times it just needs to be tested. And then out of those ideas, out of those dreams, comes the real idea.
There are some people that might be stubborn, we'll use that word,
okay,
or that don't realize that they may need help. Mm. What do you say to people that are dreaming of an idea for a business, mm-hmm, but don't think that they need consulting or coaching or any outside help?
What I do is I point to the numbers, because the numbers never lie, okay? In this area, over 90% of businesses close in 5 years.
Wow, that's a huge number.
The numbers don't lie. So I point to 90% of people thought they could do it on their own.
Before someone starts a business, mm-hmm, what are key things that they need to do?
Plan, 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 and then plan some more. In fact, I wrote an article for Edge Magazine where I said, ready, set, plan, because that's the major thing that new business owners don't do. Everyone wants to just sell something, and you have to plan. You have to get to the resources that are available to you and use those resources to build your plan before you start actually implementing to selling something.
Most businesses, what do they forget to do when they're starting off?
Build a team.
Very, very important thing to do.
Yes, yes, because most times they want to do it on their own, and they don't want to work with anybody, or they don't want to work it for anybody. But they forget that all of us have weaknesses, and you need to build a team who can complement your weaknesses.
Do you think that's due to lack of funds or lack of knowledge?
Lack of knowledge. Most like, yes, lack of knowledge and lack of the importance of networks.
What is the point in which people have to say, we need to re-strategize? You know, there's that point in which in the business may not be going as well. Mm-hmm. Do they just work through it, or do they need to re-strategize? What is your point of view on that?
My point of view on it is try it. I mean, the thing about small businesses is what we have over big boxes is we can make a decision and make a turn like a car. Big businesses turns like ships, and they have to turn very slowly. We have to use that flexibility to our advantage. If something is not working, then don't you lose all that you have. You know, being headstrong, be married to the success of the business and not the success of the process.
Interesting. And how do you know what the process, being married to the process, is?
When you're losing money.
That's
a great indicator.
That's a fundamental point. A lot of people have the impression that startups are meant to lose money the first few years. Is that true?
Well, not necessarily. Not necessarily, because there are some viable ways of gaining money. The thing about it is you're not, statistically speaking, you're not supposed to make profit for 18 to 36 months, Okay, that's the thing. But that's because you're reinvesting into your business and you're expanding and you're growing. What I actually teach business owners to do is to start as small as possible, test your idea and retest it. The people that surround me who have taught me business, we all believe in start testing ideas long before you commit, overcommitting to your business. And so there is some profitability that you don't get the first few years. However, that's because you started very small. And so when you are making money, you're reinvesting and growing that way.
When does a company have to say, okay, it's time to get to our next level and we need to get a business coach? So an established business that needs to get to the next level.
You need a business coach from the beginning. let's get that first.
Okay. But for those that don't have it,
There are resources that, like the Tennessee Small Business Development Center, has a coach that's free. So there's no excuse.
There's no excuse for any business to not have a business coach.
There's no excuse not to have a coach. Now, a paid coach is a different thing, but the generic information is there for you and it's available for you, and you've paid for it with your taxes, so why not use it?
Absolutely. I know that you have an event coming up.
I do.
That's for the community and that everyone should partake of. Please tell me about this.
Elevate 2017 is about raising your standards, whether it's personal development, professional development, or a business idea. I have brought together a group of people who are going to elevate Chattanooga on March the 4th, 2017 at the Finley Lecture Hall at the Chattanooga Choo Choo.
And I know you have many different events going on that day within your big event.
Yes.
So tell us a little bit more about that.
So I'm bringing in Jenny DeFreshney from Oceanside, California. She was the creator of the first all-boy charter school in D.C. I have Karen Ald, who's coming from Jersey. She is the weight coach. She has the butt reduction. And when I say butt reduction, it's BUT reduction. People that say, but this, I would be that, but that. She's that
interesting
person. Yeah, I have a comedian. I have several local speakers coming who are going to help us be unstuck.
Thank you so much, Linda. We look forward to your event.
Thanks
on March the 4th, right?
March the 4th from 1 to 6 at the Chattanooga Choo Choo. Tickets are available on Eventbrite.
Perfect. Next up, Nikki Nicholson will talk to us with Queen to Queen.
I'm Nikki Nicholson, and welcome back to Point of View. Well, Queens to Queen or Style Swap? Now, I know you're wondering what these two things could possibly have in common. Well, today, our special guest, Teresa Adams, the founder of Queens to Queens, and Mallory Kennedy, the event planner of Queens to Queens, are here to tell us how and what Queens to Queen is and how you can also be a part of Style Swap. Welcome to joining us today.
Thank you for having us today.
Awesome. Well, let's just jump right on in. Okay. Teresa, what exactly is Queens to Queen?
Queen to Queen is a women's group that uplift one another. Women are so hard on each other, and we don't realize how we are our worst enemy. Mm. We are constantly in competition with one another. This group is to let you know that we do not have to be in competition. We can build each other up, and we can both reach the top without competing and pulling each other down.
So yes. What in your life brought you to the point to where you said, you know what, I need to make this group?
Well, what actually started the group in 2015, I was going through some hard times in my life. I went through some personal challenges, and I was not happy. And I went for a while and just being unhappy, just going through the motions, as we as women do. We go through the motions, we have this happy face on, everything is good, but on the inside we're broken and we're hurting. And that's where I was at that time. I was broken and I was hurting. And I was sitting at work one day and I said to myself, this has got to stop. And I got to thinking, if I'm feeling this way and I'm going to work every day and I've got this smile on my face and everybody thinks that everything is going just perfect,
right.
But when I get home, it's a whole different thing. I take off that mask, and that's what we talk about in the group, taking off that mask and being you.
So is that like what just made you just step out Like, was it someone that you actually needed to talk to? Did you feel like you needed a sister, someone closer than a friend that you could just talk to? Is that what made you say, you know what, we need this as women?
Good question. What made me start this group is once I came to the realization, if I'm going through this and I'm going through the mask of covering up, how many more women are doing this every day? Going to work with a smile on their face, but they are struggling with things inside. Personal issues, health issues, whatever it is, how many more women are going through hard times as I was? And so I started the group. The first day I actually started the group, we had 600 members the first day.
600 members.
And it's been going
strong. So where did you start the group? Was it on social media? Was it on all social media?
It was on Facebook.
On Facebook.
Started on Facebook. The first day we started on Facebook, put it out there. Like I said, the first day, over 600 members. We have women in there now of all nationalities. Because we
so
say,
it's touching people, not just in the city of Chattanooga,
but
all over.
California, we have people in Kenya, we have people in Africa, we have people all around the world, women in the group, that are going through something and they just need that encouragement. We speak about flying, F-L-Y, first love yourself.
First love
you
yourself.
Have to love yourself first before you're able to reach out and love someone else. So that's what we're trying to get women to get to that point. You may not be perfect. You may not look perfect. You may have bulges here and there. You may have a scar. Whatever the issue is, you're still a queen. You're still beautiful. You're still worth it. And we want every woman to know, regardless, you are a queen. You're worth it.
You are a queen and you're worth it. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm loving what I'm seeing and I'm hearing already. I love the fact that you can reach out all over the world and you may not have a biological or blood sister, or you may have that and still need that person who can actually just connect with. So this is amazing, and I know that you have a lot of events going on. Mm-hmm. Tell me about the next event you have.
Well, the next event that we have coming up is called our Style Swap event. We want to do something fun. We all love fashion. Mm-hmm. We all look at each other like, ooh, I wish I had that in my closet, or I wish I could wear that.
So, I love the necklace.
Exactly.
Let me say.
So that's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be coming together on April the 22nd at the Walker Pavilion at Coolidge Park from 1 to 4 p.m. To be a vendor, it's only $15. So bring your clothes, bring your style, your fashion, skin care, hair care, whatever you do. We just want to get as many women together as possible to just have a good time together and swap some things.
So how so that's how you came up with the name. Mm-hmm. You're swapping items.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. That is amazing.
Yes.
So I believe that's going to be like a really good turnout, because there's nothing like going in your sister's closet and saying, well, can I borrow? Or do you mind?
That
or
still
can
happens to me to this day.
Exactly. So this will be a lot of sisters coming together and being able to swap and just tell stories and just help each other grow.
Exactly.
So we only have 3 minutes left, ladies. So I would love for you to tell the women how they can become a part of this group.
Well, you can become a part of Queen to Queen. We actually have a website that was up and running, and we want to congratulate Mallory, who got that started for us. It is www.queentoqueenwomensministry.com. You can also go on Facebook. We're on Facebook. Queen to Queen. You can also go on Instagram. We are also on Instagram. So we're on trying to reach out to as many people as possible.
That's awesome. So again, I know they have many events, and are there any other events that you want to let people know? And
well, we'll have a fireside chat event coming up in June.
What's that?
Fireside chat.
Fireside chat.
Yes.
Okay.
It's one of the mixers that I went to, and that's how I got started in the ministry. And I was like, this is amazing. I was like, I don't know why I didn't get, you know, a part of the ministry sooner. But one of the main things that we will have coming up is going to be next year. It is our unveiling of the Unbreakable Woman.
Yes.
This is something that we are planning, and we want it to be a very special an amazing event, and so that is something that we'll have coming up next year, and you'll hear all about it, of course, if you visit our social media and the website, but we are really, really, really excited about that event.
Unveiling of the Unbreakable Woman.
Unveiling of the Unbreakable Woman.
So I'm sure there'll be speakers there as well.
Yes.
Well, I'm excited to hear about that. I can't wait for that. I will be in attendance.
Yes.
And thank you, ladies. Thank you so much for joining us. I look forward to having you come back on the show to talk about other events that you're bringing to the city of Chattanooga.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you. A place for youngsters to go on the next Point of View.
Closed captioning provided by the following.
Funding for this program is brought to you by Barnett & Company, specializing in tax-efficient strategies for the preservation and distribution of family wealth, offering continuous investment management with a focus on long-term strategies. Areas of service include investment, estate, education, and retirement planning. Barnett & Company, the power of compound returns over time. More information can be found on the web at barnettandcompany.com.
You make me wear my bike helmet.
You taught me never to run with scissors.
And to follow the swimming rules.
You tell me to stay away from drugs.
To always buckle my seatbelt.
So why do you keep a loaded gun in your drawer?
How safe is that?
You ask them to follow some safety rules, now they're asking you. In fact, they're counting on you. Never let your gun get into the wrong hands. Remember, always lock it up. Visit ncpc.org.
They said a bottle was just a bottle. That no one would ever notice me. But I knew I could be more. That one day, I would make people smile.
Did you know kids who play outdoors have healthier lungs?
Totally.
Did you know that boys that play with dolls make better husbands?
My son has lots of dolls.
But did you know terry cloth diapers breathe better?
I did.
Mm-hmm. It's totally true.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Did you guys know statistically friendly kids have more friends?
Yeah. That's obvious.
Did you know most people think they're using the right car seat for their kid, but they're not?
Parents who really know it all know for sure that their child is in the right seat. Visit safercar.gov/the right seat to make sure your child is protected.
Give it back!
They'll test you. Try to break your will. But however loud the loudness gets, however many cheese puffs may fly, you're the driver, the one in control. Stand firm. Just wait. And move only when you hear the click that says they're buckled in for the drive. Never give up till they buckle up.